Hello and welcome to St Mary's Primary Academy. My name's Mark Ford and I'm the head teacher here. So our approach here at St Mary's is very much about community, both within school and outside of school. Within school, we've built a strong learning community based on fundamental Christian values. Things like respect, kindness, forgiveness, love, care, and so on. And we've used those to underpin what we develop in our learning environments. So at St Mary's, you will find a caring, loving, and nurturing learning environment where children are valued for themselves, for their individuality, and where learning is catered and personalised for them. You find a place where they are nurtured. You'll find a place where their needs are catered for, whatever those needs be. We look at the individual child, we look at their family, and we work with them. We do our best to ensure that they receive the best education they can and make the best progress they can. Our Christian values underpin everything we do, but in a multicultural society, we respect all religions and are welcoming to children from all backgrounds, ethnicities, and so on. Across school, we do our very best to make sure that everyone feels part of our family here. Every class has a support assistant who has a significant pastoral role and can take the cares and the concerns of the children, leaving the teacher to be able to focus on the teaching and learning. That doesn't mean to say that the teachers aren't involved in the pastoral side either, but it gives that support network. It gives that extra something that the children can rely on. Our approach allows children to develop both academically and personally, pastorally. And we value our strong pastoral and welfare team. We feel that's the strength of our school. And that strength has shown through in the last few months significantly, where our welfare team have been active in the community, delivering food parcels, delivering food vouchers, delivering work packs, and simply doing check-in meetings and welfare calls with families who have been vulnerable and found it difficult during the pandemic. School not only provides for your children during the normal day, but we also have a breakfast club which operates from 8 a.m. up to the start of school. And we also have our own in-house school-led after-school club, which runs from the end of school to 5:30 most nights. This wraparound care enables you as parents to be able to work your busy lives around our school times and ensure that your children are always cared for at all times. This is in addition to the usual after-school activities that we provide, such as sports clubs, art clubs, science clubs, and so on, which operate usually during the normal routine of school. Within the school, we have one of the most dedicated and committed staff teams you could probably meet. I've personally been head teacher for nearly 18 years and have enjoyed every moment of that and made it a real significant part of my life. The time that I've invested has paid off in the support I get from my staff and the work that they put in, going the extra mile all the time to make sure that children here enjoy their time, feel valued, and are part of a lovely, caring, nurturing learning community. We also feel community outside the school is very important, and we are very active in terms of working with local agencies, particularly Hunslet Children's Centre, who share our site, which means that on our site here in the centre of Hunslet, as a hub for the community, we can cater for children from the age of 2 to 11 in a combination of time with the Children's Centre and here in school. Recently, the school has benefited from its partnership with the Collaborative Learning Trust, a group of schools across the city who share ideas and work together to improve the life chances of the children under their care. This has been a real positive for our school and has really, really helped us develop our provision, improve our provision, and push ourselves so much further on to ensure that children in our school reach even higher standards. Starting school in reception can be quite a daunting event for such small children, but we go the extra mile to make sure that they are settled fully into the school routines. Under normal circumstances, children from reception are paired up and buddied up with children from year four, who spend time with them in free time, help them at lunchtime, and go around school with them at different times of the day. The children from reception gradually join us for assembly throughout the year, growing into the school, becoming part of the school community as they grow and learn through their reception year. Under normal circumstances, transition arrangements would include visits from our nursery team to your children in their current setting, preschool or nursery. We do home visits usually, where children are visited in the home. We do pre-visits to the setting and various other activities. Obviously, should the pandemic continue, we cannot operate all of those, but we can make sure the transition runs smoothly. This year we operated Teddy Bears Picnics, where a limited number of children were invited down together onto the field in August. We then had time for limited groups of children to work in the setting, and they remained like small groups until finally coming in full time and forming their own bubble within school. Ideally, as in normal years, we would be inviting parents down to come and look around school, and we would have open mornings and sessions where they can see how we really work with our children. Circumstances mean that we have to do it a different way. Please feel free to call and we can possibly arrange an individual tour for you, so that when you come down, you will really, really see what we can do for your child. You can come down and see how we will work with your child. We will care for them. We will help them develop in every way that they can to ensure that they are prepared fully for the next stage in their education. We are passionate about what we do here. The staff team are passionate and the children are passionate too. And we hope to see you in September.
Victoria's settled in really well. She was a little bit unsure the first couple of days, but the staff, particularly Miss Chin, I felt that she made Victoria feel really comfortable. How she's engaged with the parents as well, it's been brilliant. She's made, particularly myself, feel very comfortable about Victoria coming here. And now Victoria gets excited on the morning. She wakes up and she's like, come on, get ready, Dad. I want to go to school. We're going to be late. Come on. And she's pushing me to leave the house, which I don't know many children that are like that. So I know that she's settled in really well, given her enthusiasm to come to school. The teddy bear picnic that Miss Chin arranged and then the stay and play session were really helpful. I believe, you know, it introduced Victoria to a couple of other students that she'd be with, and it showed parents where to come and where the children were going to be, and given that comfort of, yes, this is where they're going to be, this is a safe environment for my child. The reason we chose St Mary's is because it's a faith school. It's important for Victoria's family setting, as a mum's religious. I attended a faith school myself, and I found that the environment at the faith school were a lot more engaging than a regular school. The staffs always seem to be a lot friendlier. I don't know if that's anything to do with the schools or just the staff, but certainly the staff here are very friendly. It's somewhere with close transportation links for if ever I need to take public transport. I feel it's in a safe environment as well. Yeah, there's a main road close by, but there's plenty of quiet roads for if you need to park. It's a quiet, safe space to wait for your child on a morning and on an afternoon for drop off and pick up. And it's an open area. It feels safe. I've also got a friend whose child comes to this school, and she told me personally, this is the best school you can go to. And just everything I've read online from friends that have come here, it just made me feel that this was the right choice of school. Every day it's putting me at ease of, yeah, the staff here really care. They're looking out for my child's best interests and addressing any other parents' concerns that come along with that as well.
For me, I believe that she's enjoying herself, but She told me last time that she made some couple of friends that which she enjoyed playing with, and which I was really happy about that. And she tells me the things that she likes doing in school as well. And she now has started learning her sound as well, which I was quite shocked. Because we tried that during the lockdown. I couldn't get her. I even put on the TV, I couldn't. But just like that, with a book that the teacher gave her, she was like making a sound. I was like, oh wow, school is good. The transition into school was straightforward for her. She enjoyed it. It was sad for me because I couldn't come in, you know, like we did last time, but it was straightforward. She enjoyed herself. Her first day, she enjoyed it. The teachers, you guys are welcoming. Literally, you're easy to approach. You know, if I have issue, I can come in anytime. I say I need to speak to Mr. Ford, you'll be available to have a chat, a quick chat. So the teacher, the learning, and the kids enjoy it as well. So they have quite a bond with the teacher as well. It's really good.
Welcome to reception. My name is Miss Jess Crisp and I'm the early years leader here. We're delighted that you're considering sending your child to our school. At St Mary's, we are passionate about giving the children the best possible start to their education journey. We do this by providing an environment which is warm, friendly, and safe for the children. Our priority is that the children feel confident, happy, and excited to come to school every day. We know that the transition from nursery to reception can be a daunting time for the children and for their families. And we work hard to make sure that that transition process is as smooth as possible. Before COVID times, we would spend a lot of our summer term working on transition. This included visiting the children in their nursery and arranging stay and play sessions for the children and the families in school. We work closely with Hunza Little Owls Children's Centre to get to know the children as best we can before they start school. Then, in September, before the children started school, we arranged a home visit for each child so we could begin to build our relationships with our new families. Miss Chin is our reception teacher and she is going to explain how we arranged our transition this year.
This year we had a teddy bears picnic in early September where we invited the children and their parents and carers to come and have a picnic with a teddy and we played some games and read a story. This gave the children opportunities to meet new friends before they started in September. We also had stay and play sessions and transition visits where the children visited the classroom first with their parents and carers, where the parents could ask any questions they wanted, and then in small groups of up to 6 children, where they were able to play in the classroom, inside and outside, and meet their teacher, me, and the nursery officer as well. The children then started school doing half days for a week, and then their full day started after that.
In reception, the children have access to the indoor and outdoor provision. Our curriculum aims to educate our children with the knowledge, skills, and understanding that they need to be effective, curious, resilient, and independent learners. At the heart of our curriculum are the characteristics of effective learning and the children's well-being. Ms. Chin is going to show you around our reception classroom and talk about the experiences that the children have in school.
In our reception, children are encouraged to follow their interests and make independent choices about their learning, alongside being supported by adult interactions to develop thinking and language skills. We aim to provide a wide range of areas in our provision to allow a broad range of learning opportunities. This is the transient art area and finger gym, where the children's activities will be reflected by the current topics. Our topic at the moment is autumn, so the children can explore leaves and different objects to make pictures and cut them up here. The mark making area helps to provide opportunities for children to develop their early writing skills. We try to have a wide range of stimuluses for children to explore and mark make about. The home corner supports imaginative play and it allows children to bring their own experiences into their play. We try to have real things in the home corner like real food, used telephones and real food packaging to help support those imaginative experiences. This is part of our outdoor area here in reception. The children can play out here at various points throughout the day. They can choose between inside and outside. We reflect lots of different areas here outside as well, such as small world, imaginative play, physical development, such as using scooters, spinny tops and tyres and building. And we also have lots of natural exploration as well. We have a mud kitchen for the children to dig and explore in. We also bring other elements outside, such as reading, map making and imaginative play as well.
Every child at our school is recognised as a unique individual, and we celebrate and welcome differences in our school community. Throughout the time here in reception, the children develop a sense of belonging to our school community. They develop the confidence, knowledge and skills they need to move on to the next stage of their education and to develop a lifelong love of learning.
We're very proud of our early years provision, which we're extending into year one more and more this year to give the children that really firm, strong foundation in their learning. Our early years provision's been applauded by the local authority on a number of occasions. We often get visitors to come and see the good practice that's going on here. And we feel it's really important because it gives our children a really, really solid start to their time in school. They get a real experience-based learning in their first few terms, right through till Christmas of year one and beyond for those that need it. And that really builds a strong foundation for what they're going to do further on through school.
Last week we were doing poetry because it was National Poetry Week. We made our own pop-up books and stuff. It was really fun. And now we're writing a story. Yeah, Long Division. We've done Long Division last week. We got it at first, and then the next day it was like,
I can't do it.
It was chaos. And then the next day we got it again. So Mr. Pemberley said, every day at the end of maths, we're going to do one long division. The teachers are really good, especially like
the teachers who work in the office.
Yeah, especially them, because like they run after school club and breakfast club. So I think that's really good, because like if your mum's working and stuff and your dad's working and you've got no one to look after you, you can go to after school club. But if you have to get up early because of your mum's work and stuff, you can go to breakfast club. That's what I really like. Yeah. And the other teachers, they're just good in general.
Yeah, all of the teachers.
The school dinners taste really good. I remember I used to love the sausage, and my dad cut up my sausages and put them in the mash and then I'd eat them together. I can't pick which. Okay, I'd say fun and educative.
Educational.
Educational.
Pick one, Liam. Or two. Or three. Phenomenal?
Phenomenal. It was one of our year three words. We had like year three and four, we had like a wall, and it said like
it's the word of the day, or was it word wall of the week?
It was word of the week. And then I went home and I always looked up the word, and then I know the word straight away.
So my name is Jo Williamson, or Ms. Williamson to the children. I think I have two or three roles in school. My main role is safeguarding. I'm the child protection officer for the school, which obviously the key part of that is keeping the children safe. But a lot of that involves family support, so helping out families when they get stuck, when they're struggling, building up those good relationships with families so they know they can come to us when they need help, signposting them to agencies that can support them, working with other professionals across the city that can help families, all about supporting the child and working together, us, the family and anyone else, to help that child and keep them safe. Sometimes that means in school working one-to-one sometimes and doing nurture activities, su- supporting children with emotional well-being in school and things like that when they need it. As part of my role, I work quite closely with our Senko. We share an office, so we have times when we're together, and there's sometimes children whose emotional well-being means that it can affect their progress in school, so we might get together and plan how we're going to support that child, write behaviour plans and things like that. Sometimes we do refer to inclusion teams, and so yeah, we all work together really in that way. And then the other thing that I do in school, along with my colleague Debbie, we run the after school care for the school. So we have, in school we have wraparound care, as you probably know, we have breakfast club and we have the after school care. So when the children all finish around 3 o'clock, any that stay whose parents are at work can come with us into the hall, and we're here till 5:30 every day, and it's a really child-led environment. So we provide activities, but the children get to choose what to do. It's not a case of us saying, okay, everybody's doing this today. We get to know the children, we get to know what they're interested in, what activities they like, and we do all sorts of things, play games, arts and crafts, we play outside, and we give them what we hope is a healthy snack. We have things like fruit and yogurt and things like that. We've got today a little boy that's coming to see us. It's his birthday, so we're going to have a little bit of a celebration today for his birthday. So obviously I said our school is very family orientated, but within our little after school club with those regular children, we have this little family there where we're all together, which is really nice. I think parents tend to worry about if the child will be happy at school. That's the big one. Will they have friends? Will they be happy? Are they school ready? You know, are they going to be able to manage without the parent there in the classroom? And of course they are, because they always do. You know, we've got an amazing early years team, which that's one of my roles. I'm early years trained and started off here working in reception, so I work with the early years team. And the parents can come in and stay as long as they need to with the child. Children, I mean, we've done things for children in the past where we've staggered how long they spend at school. So if they're not comfortable on their first day, and it's really, really difficult, they don't have to stay for the full day. Lots and lots of reassurance, I think, for parents, and that the team are just amazing. They're always there for the children. So, and everybody's in that boat, everybody's new, but children are always ready for school, you know, they're settling really, really quickly, so. I think we have a strong, it's a family, I think that's the main thing. We as a team are very supportive of each other and of the families that come here, and it's just got a very caring atmosphere, and we're all about that pastoral care. If children are worried or parents are worried, then that's going to have an impact on progress and on achievement. So if everybody's happy, you know, then we do better. So we all work together for that. We want the children here to thrive and to be happy at school. Just reassuring them that it's fine. We're at that age and we go to school. They're likely to be with some of their friends from nursery. They will make new friends. They can come and visit whenever they want. The parents can bring them. They can come for little visits, and so we always have a visit. But if children need more than that, they're very welcome to come again and get to know the staff. Always tell the children that if they are worried, to go and speak to one of the grown-ups. Don't just hold it in. You know, we are there to help. And also, if like I said, if the child is really upset with anything or really worried, we'll ring the parents and talk to the parents. And it might be that the parents bob back in and settle them, or come and take them home for a little while, or, you know, we all work together to help the child. So there's no need to be worried. I mean, I've worked here a long time, and being early-ish trained. The child is always is central to everything. Everything is you know, is child-led. So I think whatever, any concerns, any worries, whether that be an academic worry, a school issue, whether that's something that's changed within the family that is causing the child upset or the parents are struggling with, school is with them on that. We work together, we're a team, us and the family. I call it the team around the child. So we all work together because we want the best for the child, as do the parents. So I would just say to parents, you know, if you are struggling or you're worried about anything, please do come and talk to us, because we're on the same team, we're with you on that.